If you're a musician or a singer and would like to record yourself but really don't know how and where to get started, then you've come to the right place. Stay tuned. Hello friends, my name is Waldemar Martens. First of all, if you're new to this channel, you may want to check out my music videos that I've done. You can find them on this channel. And also, if you're interested in tutorials about music production, then hit the subscribe button and also that bell notification button to stay tuned, because there's some things coming up in the near future. If you have been playing music or singing for a while, then you naturally come to a point where you would like to record yourself, record some cover songs or maybe even your own songs, do your own arrangements, show it to friends or maybe publish it on the internet. And maybe you don't really know how to get started with that and what you need for that, or maybe you're scared about the technology, but I would like to show you that it's really not that hard to do, and I will show you 5 things that you need to record yourself. Let's get started. So the first thing that you need, you probably already have, it's a computer. No matter whether it's a desktop computer, a laptop, whether it's an Apple or a PC, it really doesn't matter. And also, you may be wondering whether you need a particularly powerful computer, and actually the answer is no. If you've bought your computer during the last 5 years, chances are that it's probably powerful enough to do the job. The only important thing is that it has a USB port, such that you can connect an audio interface to the computer, but more about that later. The second thing that you will need is obviously a microphone, and maybe you even already have a microphone at home and you may be wondering whether it's suitable or not. Well, there are different kinds of microphones. For getting started, I would just check whether it has an XLR jack. It's this jack that has 3 pins in it, and then it will be suitable to connect to an audio interface. If you would like to buy a microphone and would like to have a recommendation, I would recommend the Rode NT1A microphone, which is a really great value for the price. It's a condenser microphone. You can use it for recording vocals, for recording instruments. It's a really versatile microphone, and for the price, it's a really great value. The microphone on its own costs typically around 154 euros, but there are also sets available where you get the pop shield to prevent plosive sounds, the shock mount, and also a cable and a microphone stand, which you will also need. And for instance, there are offers by Thomann where you get the set, everything included, for 175 euros. The third thing that you will need is an audio interface. This is basically a device that is needed to connect your microphone or your instrument to the computer. There are many really cheap options on the market, around 100 euros typically. That's where it gets started. One example that I could recommend is the Focusrite Scarlett Solo interface. It has an XLR jack where you can connect your microphone like the Rode NT1A. It has a 48 volts phantom power, which you'll also need for that microphone. And then it also has an instrument input where you can connect, for instance, a guitar or a bass guitar. And then it has a headphone output where you can connect your headphones to monitor what you're recording. And also, if you would like to connect speakers, that also has outputs for that. So it really is a minimum solution for this kind of thing. And the advantage is that this particular model is powered by USB, so the only thing that you will need is just a USB cable. You connect it to your computer and you're ready to go. Then of course you will have to hear what you're recording, and for that you will at least need a pair of headphones. Chances are that you already have a few headphones, like from your mobile phone. If you would like to buy a pair of headphones, I can recommend you a really cheap and good solution for the price. It's the Superlux HD-681. It comes at an incredible price of 20 euros. I have a couple of pairs of this headphone myself. I use it for recording vocal ensembles, and I must say, for that price, it's really an unbeatable headphone. The last thing that you will need is a software to record your audio, your vocals, your instruments. And I myself, I use Cubase. There are also cheap versions of that software, but if you maybe want to have a free option, I would recommend the software StudioOne by Presonus. It comes completely free and has an unlimited number of audio tracks. You can do all the basic recording things and mixing things, and it's really completely free. The only thing that you will need to do when you install the software is to select the audio interface that you got connected to your computer, and then you should be ready to get started. Alright guys, these were 5 things you will need to record yourself, and I got a 6th thing for you, because I think on the long run monitoring through headphones is not really ideal. And if you would like to invest into a pair of studio monitors, which you will need if you want to do it more seriously, then I can recommend the KRK Rocket RP5 or the slightly larger RP7 models. These are not high-end monitors, but they are very good for the price, and it's certainly better than monitoring through headphones on the long run. You don't need any additional amplifier to use your interface with those monitors. You can directly connect the output of your interface to those monitors and you're ready to go. If you now sum up the prices for the 5 items that I've listed, assuming that you already have the computer and excluding the loudspeakers, you end up with a total of €294, which I think it's quite an amazing price. If you consider what you get for it and compare it with what you would have paid 20 or 30 years ago, because at that time you really didn't have that technology. You maybe needed to rent a studio to get access to this kind of recording equipment, and today you really will be able, with one microphone and your computer, essentially record a whole album. All right, that was it for today. I hope it was helpful. If it was, give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment down below if you have a question. I'm happy to answer and help out if you need any clarifications. I'll put a link down below to the recording software Presonus StudioOne, such that you can download it. And otherwise, see you in the next video. Bye bye.